Did you know that securing your Windows PC with a password doesn't stop most people from being able to access your files? It is very easy to boot a live operating system from a USB stick or a CD and browse unencrypted hard drives. So if you don't want to give up your digital privacy easily, you should consider encrypting your hard drives. It's quite easy to do and doesn't get in your way in everyday use. Of course, there's a lot of encryption software on the market from companies like Microsoft, McAfee or Symantec. But depending on who you want to protect your data from, using closed software with no way to check its security might not be the best solution. This is VeraCrypt, a free and open source encryption software for hard drives and volumes. It's a fork of the popular but discontinued software TrueCrypt, with improved security and fixed issues. VeraCrypt has been audited for weaknesses by an external cybersecurity company, and the software is available for Windows, macOS, Linux, FreeBSD 11 and Raspbian. Let me show you how easy it is to make use of your basic right to privacy and encrypt your PC. We start by downloading the software from the official website veracrypt.fr. Now would be a good time to make sure you have a backup of your files. There's always the little possibility that things might go wrong, so make sure you can recover your files. When you're done, launch the installer and accept the license terms. Since we want to encrypt our system drive in this case, meaning the hard drive Windows is installed on, choose Install. Of course, consider making a donation to the developer later if you like the software. Now start VeraCrypt and choose System and Encrypt System Partition / Drive. Then you have the option to encrypt normally or create a hidden operating system. The second option is used in case you should be pressured into giving away your password, so you can give up a fake password. Since this hopefully isn't expected in our case, we choose a normal install. Next, select whether to encrypt only the Windows system partition or the whole drive. Encrypting the whole drive is usually a good idea. Now the software asks if the host protected area should be encrypted. This is a special area on the hard drive, where for example tools for system recovery are stored. To be safe and not break anything, I choose No. If you only have one operating system installed on this computer, choose Single Boot. This is probably the usual case. Otherwise, if you have multiple operating systems installed, for example multiple versions of Windows, choose Multi-Boot. Then it's time to choose an encryption and hash algorithm. You don't have to change anything, but it's nice to know that there are different algorithms available, even nested into each other. This is one of the most important parts, choosing a password. A good password should be more than 20 characters long. It's not really important that it is really complicated, but it should be long, so maybe try a short sentence you can remember. Be aware that the actual password window later uses a US keyboard layout, so some keys may be switched for other countries. No worries, you get the chance to test everything before actually encrypting your drive. You also have the option to use a PIM. That stands for Personal Iterations Multiplier. It is not mandatory to use, but does speed up your boot time or increases security. As long as your password is long enough, you can set the PIM to something like 20. This way your boot time is a lot faster, since your computer has to calculate less to decrypt your files. You need to enter this number along with your password when booting your PC. Now VeraCrypt collects random data to improve the cryptographic strength. Move your mouse randomly within the window. The last step of the setup is creating a rescue disk. You will need it in case the VeraCrypt loader is damaged or the encryption is corrupted. You can then decrypt your PC in case of emergency. Burn the ISO file to a CD by double-clicking it later. I will skip the rescue disk verification for this tutorial. In the wipe mode window, VeraCrypt offers to wipe your hard drive. This would delete your files. So if you don't want to set up a blank system, choose None. Your files will only get encrypted in place and not deleted. Now it's time to test all settings by doing a test boot. You will have to enter your password and optionally PIM after restarting, just like you would after encryption. The This is what the password entry screen looks like. Enter your password, press enter, then enter your PIM if you set one. Hit enter again to confirm. If everything worked, Windows should boot normally now. Back in Windows, VeraCrypt will now offer to actually start the encryption. After confirming the info text, the process starts. It usually takes a few hours. If you need to pause and shut down your PC, you can click on Defer. You then can continue the encryption process at a later time. When everything is finished, your hard drive has been successfully encrypted. Encrypting a non-system hard drive works similar. In VeraCrypt, click on Volumes, then Create New Volume, and choose Encrypt a non-system partition / drive. In case you get stuck or something goes wrong, make sure you read the info text on the screen. Usually everything is explained in the software or on the VeraCrypt website.